With this noble and agreeable youth lived I in perfect joy and constancy. He was full bent on keeping me to himself, for the honey month at least, but his stay in London was not even so long, his father, who had a post in Ireland, taking him abruptly with him on his repairing thither. Yet even then I was near keeping hold of his affection and person as he had proposed, and I had consented to follow him in order to go to Ireland after him, as soon as he could be settled there. But meeting with an agreeable and advantageous match in that kingdom, he chose the wiser part, and forbore sending for me, but at the same time took care that I should receive a very magnificent present, which did not, however, compensate for all my deep regret on my loss of him. This event also created a chasm in our little society, which Mrs. Cole, on the foot of her usual caution, was in no haste to fill up, but then it redoubled her attention to procure me in the advantages of a traffic for a counterfeit maidenhead, some consolation for the sort of widowhood I had been left in, and this was a scheme she had never lost prospect of, and only waited for a proper person to bring it to bear with. But I was, it seems, fated to be my own caterer in this, as I had been in my first trial of the market. I had now passed near a month in the enjoyment of all the pleasures of familiarity and society with my companions, whose particular favourites, the baronet excepted, who soon after took Harriet home, had all on the terms of community established in the house, solicited the gratification of their taste for variety in my embraces. But I had, with the utmost art and address, on various pretexts, eluded their pursuit without giving them cause to complain, and this reserve I used neither out of dislike of them or disgust of the thing, but my true reason was my attachment to my own and my tenderness of invading the choice of my companions, who, outwardly exempt, as they seemed, from jealousy, could not but in secret like me the better for the regard I had for, without making a merit of it to them. Thus easy, and beloved by the whole family, did I go on, when one day, that about 5 in the afternoon, I stepped over to a fruiterer's shop in Covent Garden to pick some table fruit for myself and the young women, I met with the following adventure.